Since I discovered the world of computer vision, I've been fascinated by how it works and the cool project we can build with it. Today, I'm excited to share one of my recent side projects that combines my love for AI and my childhood love for Naruto. If you ever watched Naruto, you probably remember the hand seals, right? That concept of controlling the five elements using hand gestures was something really cool and creative. During my AI studies, I thought, what if I could create a computer vision system that recognized these hand seals in real time? Well, that is exactly what I did, and in this video I'm going to show you how. But before I explain how I accomplished this, let's take a glimpse at the end project. Really cool, right? Now, let's break down how I made this happen.
To start, let's briefly talk about what computer vision is. Computer vision is a field of artificial intelligence that enables computers to interpret and make decisions based on visual information from the world. Much like human vision, it involves teaching machines to understand images and videos.
If you want to build a computer vision system, you will generally follow 5 steps. First, we have image acquisition. Here you need to gather the data to train your model. The specific problem you want to solve will dictate what kind of data you need. Next, there is pre-processing. In this step, you prepare the dataset for analysis, for example, by enhancing image quality or applying noise reduction techniques. Third is feature extraction. This is where the AI model identifies important parts of the image crucial for the task, such as edges, shapes, and colors. Fourth, we have analysis and interpretation. Special algorithms are designed to recognize patterns and objects within the images. They help interpret what the data represents and understand its context. Finally, there is decision making. Based on the results of image interpretation, the system takes some action like triggering an alert or displaying information on the screen. Each of these steps builds upon the previous one, transforming raw visual data into insights and automated responses. This approach allows computer vision systems to operate effectively across many domains like agriculture, manufacture, and healthcare.
Now let's focus on a subset of computer vision that I used for this project, object recognition. Object recognition is a technology that enables computers to identify and label objects within images and videos. The process is also structured into 5 steps.
First is image input. You need data to train the model, so you use a camera or another device to capture images and videos. Second is pre-processing. Here, you clean up the dataset to improve its quality and reduce the chance of poor model performance. Third is feature extraction. Algorithms identify important parts of the image, such as shapes and textures, that help the model analyze the data. Next is comparison. The model compares these features to a database of known objects to find matches. Finally, the computer labels the objects it recognizes in the image, often drawing boxes around them to highlight their locations. This structured process allows the application to accurately recognize and provide useful information about objects captured in the images. That's why this technique is crucial for various tools like self-driving cars, facial recognition for security systems, and inspecting products on an assembly line. Now, let's get into how I applied this knowledge to create a hand seal recognition system.
After defining the problem and desired outcome, the first step was data collection. Think of data as the fuel for artificial intelligence. You can't do anything without the appropriate data.
To train the model, I needed photos of hand seals. Originally, there are 12 distinct hand seals in the Naruto universe, and these were exactly what the model needed to learn how to identify. I wrote a Python script that accessed my webcam and took 100 photos for each hand seal. The script repeated this process 12 times, each time capturing a different hand seal. In the end, I had a database of 1,200 images. Next, I needed to label the data. When working with object recognition, you must tell the model where the object is located in each image. For this task, I used a special software called CVAT. I uploaded the image to CVAT, labeled them according to hand seal it represented, and then exported the annotations into the YOLO format. If you open one of these annotation files, you will see 5 numbers arranged in one line. The first value represents the class, in this case the hand seal. The second and third numbers are the coordinates of the bound box center, while the fourth and fifth values represent the width and height of the box.
With the labeled data, I was ready to train the model. This was the most time-consuming part of the project. I tried several approaches to find the best solution.
My first approach was using HoboFlow. HoboFlow is an online platform designed to simplify the building process of computer vision systems. You upload your data, set some parameters, and it creates the AI model. I used this tool to test if my data was sufficient for training a model with acceptable precision. Surprisingly, it was. I thought 100 photos per class might be too few, but the model performed reasonably well. If you are interested in this system, check out the link to my HoboFlow project in the description below. I hope you find it helpful. Despite creating a functional model, I wanted more control over the coding process, so I decided to program the model from scratch. There are various algorithms to solve object recognition problems. I started with a simple convolutional neural network. You can see the code in the Google Colab notebook linked in the description. The initial model performed reasonably well, but it sometimes failed to predict the correct bounding box. Next, I tried more complex models, like single-shot boot-box detector. However, even using a GPU on Google Colab, I encountered memory errors. I tried reducing batch sizes and deleting variables after use, but the problem persisted. I eventually decided to move on from this approach. During this project, I used the free version of Google Colab, which has limited memory and GPU access. I think using the paid version with better hardware could have allowed me to train more complex models and increase system accuracy. After days of trial and error, I decided to use YOLO, You Only Look Once, a real-time object detection algorithm. YOLO is built on a deep CNN architecture and is known for its high accuracy and reliability. Applying YOLO to my dataset solved the hand seal detection problem effectively. Once the model was trained, I downloaded and wrote a Python script to use the AI with my webcam in real time, displaying the predictions on the screen. If you liked this video, you'll probably enjoy this another one in which I show you how I built my first PC with a $300 budget. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.